No. The player will go first, and after that he will go to the locker room. Dali su kamere okay? Are the cameras okay? Dobar dan I dobrodošli na konferenciju oči meča Liverpool Crvena zvezda. Pred vama su, kao što vidite, šef stručnog štaba Crvene zvezde, gospodin Vladan Milojevic I naš prvotimac Miloš Degenek. Prvo ću vas zamoliti da postavite pitanja Milošu, ukoliko ih imate naravno, kako bi mogao posle da se pridruži sa igračima I nastavi pripremu za trening koji ga očekuje. Izvolite.
Good day, first of all, to introduce you that in front of you are the coach Red Star and the player first. If you can put the questions to the player because he needs to go back to the training ground, please.
Izvoli.
Pitanje, treća utakmica u Ligi šampiona, da li se razlikuje od ove prethodne dve, kako su tvoje očekivanja, ambijent u ekipi I da li se spremni za ovu stvari na
nas? Spremni jesmo.
A question for Miloš. This is a third game in Champions League, and what are the expectations? What is the atmosphere in the club, and what are your expectations?
Spremni jesmo za utakmicu. Dobro smo se pripremili I večeras ćemo još dodatimo poslednji trening. Atmosfera u ekipi je fenomenalna. Svi smo dobri, svi se slažemo I radujemo se sutrašnjoj utakmici. Očekujem jednu dobru utakmicu, pa ne razlikuju se mnogo utakmice, mada prva je bila kući, ove dve su gostima, bez naše publike, ali dobro, šta je tu je, mi ćemo se pripremiti što bolje možemo I sutra da izađemo I da damo maksimum I da odigramo jednu dobru utakmicu.
The atmosphere in the club is fantastic, players are feeling in excellent mood, we are all prepared, well prepared, and we expect good match tomorrow. We are looking forward to it, and also the atmosphere within the team is fantastic, and we expect good game. This is third match, we have two matches without our supporters, but there's not much we can do. We'll do our best without supporters.
Yes.
Na prošloj utakmici Ligi šampiona susreli ste se sa jednom od najjačih napadačkih linija u Evropi I u svetu, ništa manje slabe I ovo sutrašnje nalog koje vas očekuje, koliko će vam iskustvo iz Pariza pomoći da se bolje spremite za sutrašnje meč sa Liverpoolom?
Last match you had, there was a fantastic lineup in offense, and the experience was pretty awkward. What do you think? What will happen tonight? The experience from that match, how it will influence? Because you have the same very strong lineup in attack in this team.
Pa mislim da će nam dobro doći to što smo igrali tu prošlu utakmicu sa Parizom, sa jednom jakom ekipom. Ova ekipa ne razlikuju se mnogo, mada nemaju baš tako individualne igrače kao što je Pariz imao, ali pomoći će nam sa tim iskustvom što smo igrali protiv njih I da mi dignemo naš nivo fudbala I naravno naučili smo dosta od te poslednje utakmice I spremili smo se, mislim, prilično dobro za ovu utakmicu sutra. Šef nam je dao instrukcije kako da igramo I šta da radimo, tako da mi ćemo to da iznesemo na teren Bože zdravlja I da igramo dobro I pomoći će nam u tome što znamo šta da očekujemo jer smo ih analizirali I pripremili smo se, mislim, dobro.
The experience from previous match against the very strong side was very learning experience. There won't be much difference with this, the strength of the team we are facing tomorrow. We did prepare very well. We learned from the match we had previously, and the coach and all our management prepared us well physically and psychologically for the match tomorrow.
Bože.
Miloš, the game, football game is played for goals. Can you imagine yourself scoring tomorrow?
Pa, mislim da imam pravo da kao kaže, da se sanja da se da go, fudbal se igra za golovu, pravo ste, voleo bi da dam go sutra, ali meni je prvenstveno kao odbran igrač da probam da sprečim da protivnik ne daje go. A ako ja mogu da dam go, to je plus meni, odnosno plus mom timu i naravno uz Božiju pomoć ja bi isto to voleo koliko i svi ostali ljudi u klubu i navijačima, da meni nije ni bitno ko da go za moju ekipu, meni je samo bitno da neko iz mog tima da go i da ja svoj posao odbrani odradim da ne primimo go.
Everybody has right to dream to score in these spectacular matches, and but for the team it doesn't matter who scores the goal as long as we play well. And first of all, I am a defendant. My role is to prevent the team conceding the goals. But I hope if I score, that would be extremely good bonus. But I hope the team will play well, and whoever scores will be fine.
Strahinja.
S obzirom to da si rekao da je zadatak prvo sačuvati svoju mrežu, tvoj kao štoper, koga bi izdvojio iz Liverpool ekipe kao tog direktnog rivala možda i kao nekog od toga preti najveće pasa?
Although you mentioned that you're a defensive player and your first role is to stop people scoring goals, who do you think in Liverpool offense is the one you have to pay special attention to? Who's the biggest danger to the team?
Pa mislim da oni u principu imaju tri jako dobre igrače koji igraju napred, ali mislim i da njihov zadnji vezni isto mogu da daju golove. Preti nam opasnost isto s prekida, imaju dobre igrače za skok. Mislim, ali direktno ako se gleda, ako bude igrao Firmino, Salah, Mane, ne znam, Starić, kogod bude igrao, oni su svi fenomenalni igrači i svi mogu da daju go iz bilo koje prilike, tako da to je to.
It's well known that the three people in the offensive lineup are fantastic players, whoever plays in that lineup, and we'll have to watch whoever plays, whether it's Taric, Firmino, Salah, or the others. Also, the people behind them are capable of scoring, and our role will be to try and defend from all of them. Miloš, you are tomorrow playing on one of the crucial stadiums or most famous stadiums in the world. Do you think you will have a special experience playing in it?
Pa mislim, stadion je poseban, ali meni je svako iskustvo gde ja igram, da li to bilo ovde, da li to bilo gde, u prvenstvu domaćem, meni je svaka utakmica ista. Ja igram maksimalno i ne bi toliko gledao tu atmosferu koliko mi je bitno da odradim svoj posao koji trebam, tako da se ne obraćam mnogo toj atmosferi, više gledam šta ja trebam da radim na terenu, ali sigurno da će biti ovde lepo, ali više gledam šta ću da radim na terenu nego što gledam atmosferu.
Da li ti inspiriš je naša atmosfera?
Pa da, ti neku inspiraciju sad, koliko toliko, ne menja mi nešto mnogo.
The stadium and history of it is fantastic, but to be honest, I am not bothered wherever I play. I always concentrate on my role as a defender to try to do my job well. Question of, does the stadium inspire you? I will try and do my best tomorrow anyway.
What belief, what confidence is there within the squad that you can win here and do tomorrow?
Koliko je kod vas samopouzdanje da možda možete čak i da pobedite sutra na ovom stadionu?
Look, we're confident, we're doing well in our league, at home we're playing well. Obviously it's going to be a very difficult game, we expect a difficult game, it's not going to be simple, it's not going to be easy. We're going to go in confident, we're going to go in with our heads held high and do our best. Obviously you can't predict the score, you can't predict anything. We know who we're up against and it won't be easy for us, it won't be easy for them, and we hope to get a positive result.
What do you think then is key to getting that positive result?
To get a positive result, I think we need to defend well, And obviously when we get the chance to attack, we need to do that with purpose and do it with good execution as well. Obviously, it's going to be very difficult, but I think the basics are always, if you keep the zero, if you don't concede, you've always got a chance of winning the game. So I think that's the most important thing, is to defend well, defend as a team. And obviously when we do attack, that we attack with purpose and attack as a team and do it fluently and do it as fast as possible.
You probably know about the atmosphere here as well. Is that something that you think you guys will thrive in?
Look, I think atmosphere here is good. I think atmosphere in Belgrade is a bit better. So I think we're all used to big atmospheres, because playing in our league and playing in Belgrade, playing in our stadium, the atmosphere is phenomenal. So I think that might give us a little bit of a push as well.
Hvala. Miloše, ti možeš sada da nastaviš sa pripremom za trening. Dok Miloš odlazi, ja imam samo jedno obaveštenje za vas, pošto je u toku nedelja borbe protiv diskriminacije i borba za raznovrsnost u fudbalu, ona nosi naziv Football People. Samo obaveštenje za vas da će sutra, kao i prošle godine u Ligi Evrope, i igrači napraviti pred meč zajedničku fotografiju noseći kartonski hashtag Equal Game. Eto, prosto da imate to kao informaciju i da možete da prosledite vašim čitaocima i gledaocima. Sada možemo preći i na pitanja za trenera Milojevića. Izvolite.
Now we can move on with the questions to coach Milojević.
Miloš,
please.
Miloš pričao o tome da je vaša šansa, između ostalog, da se dobro branite, ali kada pričamo o napadu, gdje je šansa Zvezde da najlakše probije tu odbranu liniju Liverpoola?
Milos was mentioning that his role and the role of the team is to be good in defense. But what do you think? What is the chance of Red Star to do something in offense as well? And how well did you prepare for that?
Pa dobro, svaki dobar napad proizilazi iz jedne dobre odbrane. Sad da bi analizirali gde je to generalno. Jako je teško na to pitanje reći, jer iz razloga zavisi od situacije do situacije. U ovom trenutku stvarno igramo protiv jedne ekipe koja ima jedan izuzetan način igre, svoj stil igre koji prvo treba neutralizovati u svakom slučaju, i sada neke druge strane probat ćemo da iskoristimo svaku moguću šansu koja nam se bude ukazala.
It is well known that a good offense comes from good defense, but to find the solution or predict how it will be played, it's impossible. It all depends on the development and the situation that raises. We all know that Liverpool has a fantastic team in all lines, especially in offense, and we hope we prepared well for their attack and defense.
Još.
Liverpool je krenuo impresivnu sezonu, ali je onda usledio niz rezultata bez pobjede koji su sad prekinuli protiv Huddersfielda. Koliko ste imali prilike da ih analizirate pred ovaj meč i da uporedite Liverpool koji je dominirao protiv svih protivnika i ovaj sada u oktobru mjesecu koji ne liči na onaj tim s početka sezona?
Liverpool had a fantastic start of the season with a lot of wins in the league, but that was stopped in recent games and they had few bad results, which they stopped with the game with Huddersfield. What do you think, how will you use the situation in your match?
Pa dobro, ne znam kako gledate da oni to nisu imali rezultata. Generalno Liverpool je jedna fantastična ekipa, to sam napomenuo, igraju jako, jako dobro od početka sezone. Imaju svoj stil igre i jednostavno neki put i kad odigrate dobro možda i ne dođe neki željeni rezultat, ali ono što je bitno, što možemo da vidimo u svakoj utakmici, to je taj stil koji, i sigurno to je pečat gospodina Klopa, koji jednostavno, znajući ga, poznajući ga, njegov rad iz Dortmunda i taj stil, malo pre već što sam napomenuo, vidimo da Liverpool je u svakoj utakmici do sada apsolutno dominirao, pravio veliki broj šansi, tako da jednostavno neki put u futbolu i ne dođe neki rezultat, a to ne mora da znači da imaju neku krizu bilo kakvu, nego jednostavno dođe takav dan.
I don't know where you got that idea that there was a dip in the form. Sometimes the results, all of they can be fantastic in a row, but even for after a good performance, you don't get the result that you really want. Knowing the style that Mr. Klopp imprinted in this team, and team is fantastic, I don't think they dropped in form. They just didn't have good results at certain points. And yeah, I think we are going to try our best to actually play and not underestimate their form.
Gledajući, Jurgen Klopp je napisao niz pohvala na račun igre vaše ekipe stila, a čini se posebno bio to isto kao impresionira načinom na koji Crvena zvezda menja stil igre tako što domaćem prvenstvu napada 98 utakmica u Evropi, kako nam pisao, samo klikne da pređe jedno jako dobar defanzivni stil igre.
Mr. Milojevic, Mr. Klopp today praised the team and the management of the team, the way you play, and he did lots of praises on all of the lines of the team, mentioning that you are very impressive in the championship of Serbia, where you play very offensive football and you are dominant in the league, but he was also impressed how you played against the very tough teams where you had to switch from the pretty offensive team into very good defensive team. Do you agree with these kinds of opinions that Mr. Klopp had?
Onako mogu da kažem da je jednostavno gospodin Klopp i ajde da kažem da je bukvalno i opisao da postoji razlog zato što jednostavno mi u grupi imamo tri ekipe, ovde pričamo o Liverpoolu kao i o Paris Saint-Germainu kao i o Napoliju, da pričamo tu samo još dve ekipe koje nisu iz Lige petice, što bi se reklo, i mi znamo, ja svesni smo toga da jednostavno gde se nalazi njihovo prvenstvo i gde se oni nalaze sad u ovom momentu u fudbalu. Sigurno je da mi u našoj ligi smo dominantni i apsolutno bi se složio sa tim. Sa druge strane, sigurno u ovom trenutku igramo protiv ekipa koje su i favoriti i sa druge strane mnogo veće iskustvo imaju nas u svim elementima, tako da eto, ne bi ja tu nešto posebno imao ništa da dodam.
It's very nice that Mr. Klopp has this opinion about our team and playing dominantly in our league is fine for us, but these teams also do really well in their divisions. All three, Liverpool, Paris Saint-Germain and Napoli, are top of their divisions, and there is really nothing more I can say to counter that, but whether they have much more experience in this competition and they have strength that we will, it's very hard to match, but we will try our best.
Two last questions, first for Dušan and then you will go, okay?
Kakva je situacija sa Vojadinom Savićem, da li se dovoljno ukoravio da sutra bude u startnoj postavi?
What is the situation with Vujadin Savić, Mr. Milojević? Did he recover and is he ready to take this place tomorrow?
Vidjet ćete sutra.
You will see tomorrow.
Yes, please.
What hopes do you have of still qualifying for the knockout phase after this group?
Kakve su vaše nade da se ipak kvalifikujete u sledeću grupu, u sledeći stadion takmičenja, pored rezultata?
Pa dobro, treba biti realan, sigurno nam nisu velike šanse, ali bilo kakva da je šansa, ljudski, sportski, nadati se bilo šta da uradimo, jednostavno imamo, pored ove utakmice sutra na Anfieldu, imamo još dve utakmice koje će se igrati u Beogradu, odnosno i jednu u Napolju, tako da mi smo sportisti, mi moramo da verujemo i u svakom slučaju koliko god šanse da bude bilo, probat ćemo da to iskoristimo.
You have to be realistic, but on the other hand, you are a old sportsman. Do hope for better results with the game tomorrow. There are another two matches in Belgrade against Napoli and Paris Saint-Germain, and we wouldn't be entering this league if we didn't have a hope that we will achieve better results. And there is always hope, which I think we can't, but we have to be realistic.
Ok, to je to. Hvala vam što ste bili.
Hvala.